I wanna waste my life with you. Oh yeah, this is not related to anything I'm gonna say in this video. Hey guys, it's Madeline here. So being a 17-year-old girl with ADHD, I tend to overanalyze anything and everything. Combine that with being a writer, music geek, poet, and wannabe English major, and you have yourself a recipe for disaster. So today, we're going to be analyzing Kids in Droves by Velvet Starlings. We're gonna rip this song to pieces, learn some new things, and probably change how you and most definitely I listen to this song for the rest of eternity. Let's do it. This is a song that I've been wanting to overanalyze for a while. When I first heard the song, it was called Chasing Time, and I just absolutely love it. I listed my top 10 favorite songs just a while ago, and this song ended up making the fourth slot. Keep in mind that this analysis is not going to be scripted, so leave it a like if you liked the video, and maybe subscribe if you want to see more. And of course, if you want one of your songs to be overanalyzed, leave a comment down below. So with that all said and done, let's get right into the analysis. It was always eating at me from the first time I heard this song. Why is it called Chasing Time?
The song's called Chasing Time.
This song is obviously talking about something negative that's happening in our lives commonly. So what exactly does that mean? What does chasing time mean? According to Google, our best friend, chasing time means to pack so many things into our schedule in so little time that we barely have enough time to accomplish all of them. I've heard in a lot of places that this song is about media overstimulation, similar to the last album's lead single, If Life Ain't Getting You High.
Have you ever seen Jack White live? He has those plastic bags where you put your phone in it. Everybody has their phones in these bags and they can't do anything, they can't use them, and they just gotta watch Jack White. But cool. It's so genius.
Anywhere.
You saw what happened with the whole Instagram thing when it went down. People just depend on it so much. Social media is just the ruler of everything right now.
The obvious lyric that can back this theory up is the lyrics in the first verse, spend your youth on tiny screens. There's a few other times in the song, in both the first verse and the second, where Christian says that he refuses to waste his time. But when I'm thinking about the definition of the term chasing time and wasting time and putting it into the perspective of media overstimulation, they really don't make sense and they're not synonymous with each other. When you take the idea of wasting time on your cell phone all the time, that makes a lot of sense. However, when you look at chasing time, how does that tie into spending your time on your phone? No matter how I look at it, it just doesn't make sense that being on your phone all the time would be an example of chasing time. I had completely finished this analysis, and I never could really connect chasing time to media overstimulation, and I knew that was a very important lyric because it was the title of the song. The title of the song is extremely important and has a profound meaning into what the song is, otherwise that wouldn't be the title of the song. You wouldn't write a political song about something that you're protesting against in the government and title the song about potatoes. However, once the song's title was changed to Kids in Droves, that is when everything started to click. I kind of skipped over Kids in Droves a bit. I didn't know what a drove was, but I did learn that a drove, what I think of is like when a lot of birds seem to fly in this huge group at once and they're all doing the same thing. That's pretty much what a drove was. I'll put the actual definition on screen right now. The kids are in droves as in they're all doing the same thing, they're all on their phones. But then I thought, wait a minute, this song isn't called Chasing Time anymore, it's called Kids in Droves. So when I completely put the idea of chasing time out of my mind and just focused on the three words, kids in droves, the lyric is literally saying that kids are following trends these days. And when you think about it, media overstimulation is one example of a trend that is happening in today's world. And then I went back to the lyric in the first verse, after spend your youth on tiny screens, were fed the news and swallowed lies. And it makes me think that I think this song is more political than it is about media in general. When you think about we're fed the news and swallowed lies, It's like a child or a baby being fed by their mother. They don't really know what to do. They don't know how to feed themselves. So when you're being fed the news, it's similar to how a baby's being fed. You don't really have your taste buds yet, and they don't really care what your taste buds are. You're developing them. So you've been fed these news since you're this tiny baby who doesn't know anything, and it's what you've just grown up to believe. Swallowed Lies makes me think of the previous song on this featured on this record, Bitter Pill. So if this is a bitter pill that's hard to swallow, but you're swallowing it, that makes it so that you're bearing through it even though it might be bitter. In the case of a political standpoint, this would mean that even though you don't think that these things are moral or right to do, you want to believe something else, you're still bearing through it because it's what you've been taught and it's what everyone else is doing. You don't want to stand out. One historical figure that is alluded to in multiple tracks across this record is John Lennon. This is an obvious conclusion to make because in Rabbit and a Gun,
the music that the peoples is just swallowing should be following the walrus's advice.
Most of the songs that John Lennon wrote in his solo career and some of the other ones in the Beatles were about love, more specifically, let's make peace, not war. Examples of this can be seen in his songs All You Need Is Love, Imagine, and
All We Are Saying. Give me a chance.
In Kids in Droves, we can see the obvious allusion to John Lennon because there are so many lyrics talking about how love is waving goodbye, or how we should love everything, love everyone, as this EP is even titled. John Lennon has been known for his many protests against politics in his songs, and this is one thing that the song will drag in with these lyrics. And it's not that uncommon to think of Christian talking out against politics. On Sold Down the River, which was another huge single from his previous EP, that song also was openly talking against politics. Hence the lyric, love is true and there's no faking it. That is the truth that they were referring to in the first verse when the song starts out with hide the truth because they're afraid of it. They're afraid to do what is moral because that means that they will lose money, that means they will lose supporters. So by hiding the truth, they are hiding what they believe to be moral or right in order to get more people to vote for them. They are trying to appeal to the majority. Another lyric, corporate zoos, can be an example of this. Corporate zoos, so we're escaping it. Corporate zoos can be alluding to the idea of those big businesses getting all the money. Another interesting lyric is, give them a sarcastic smile and love is waving goodbye. To give someone a sarcastic smile, sarcasm is the same thing as irony, when something is the complete opposite of what is expected.
Irony taught!
So to give someone a sarcastic smile would mean that you're smiling at them, as in telling them you're happy about it, but you're actually not happy about it. This could be an example of how the politicians are acting again, where how they put on a different perspective so that they can get more voters, or it could be an example of mockery, so like political satire that you see a lot around the internet these days. As for the chorus, every once in a while we can smile, pretend to love everything, love everyone. So again, where we really believe that we have these morals, every once in a while, when there's this huge tragedy that happens, such as 9/11 or a school shooting, we can pretend that we care for them, but we're really not going to do anything to stop it, which I think is really what this song is trying to say. We shouldn't just pretend, like thoughts and prayers, we shouldn't pretend that we're thinking about them, we shouldn't pretend that we care, we should actually go out and we should care, we should start trying to make changes in the government to prevent all these bad things from happening. Even in the music, we can see very particular rhetorical strategies to this idea of following trends, or breaking trends more accurately. For one, in the composition of the song, we have a lot of minor chords that go it's kind of like you're up here and you're going down and then it's going back up. And with the triplets, the chord notes, da da da, it's kind of like when you hear the song, da 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 da. It's creating suspense, and if you think of the music coming at you, it's like the music is coming closer to you and kind of threatening you, kind of shaking you a bit before going right back into the regular steady beat. It's kind of like how you start at a problem and you're slowly going down and then you're quickly going back up to that problem again. Kind of like the saying, it takes 10 times as long to put yourself back together as it does to fall apart. Additionally, at the end of the song, we have a screaming guitar solo by Christian. This is probably one of the best guitar solos that I've ever seen from him play. I actually didn't like this guitar solo when I first heard it. I thought it was unexpected, it slapped me in the face, and I wanted a little bit more warning before it came in. But if you think about it, I think that was kind of the point with it, to be unexpected. There is no warning, it's cutting off the lyrics, so for one, the lyrics love everything, love everyone, and then the guitar solo comes in, it's way louder, it's cutting off all of that, meaning we've forgotten it, or it can be alluding to the fact that he's breaking rules in the music industry. Probably the best connection I can make to this is that he's doing his own thing and not caring about what anyone else thinks. He's being himself, he's showing his own personality, and this is really who he is. After he's saying, I refuse to waste my time trying to be someone else. But after all of this, I still had to go back to that first question I had. Why are we chasing time? If you are putting so many trends that aren't true into your life, that's kind of similar to how in chasing time you're denying the fact that you really don't have the time to do all these things, but you're still doing it. This can be seen in the bridge when he says, there's no time to be yourself. We're busy being someone else. We're always chasing time. We're always trying to be like the person in front of us, and we're not giving ourselves time to develop our own styles, our own personality, our own beliefs. But in the spirit of breaking trends, we can also look at this lyric as metonymy instead of the literal definition of the word. Metonymy is when you take a part of something to represent a whole. One example of this could be all hands on deck. We're not literally just using all hands on deck. What they mean by all hands on deck is that they want everyone on deck to help out. So in this case, one part of a crew member, the hands, are being used to represent the whole of the person. In this case of the song, if you look at chasing time and you insert the in the center of these sentences, chasing the time, or plural, chasing the times, it makes sense. You are trying to keep up with all of these trends. It's taking up all of your time, and it's changing so fast, but you're trying to change with them because you want to fit in. Time would be representing the trend. It would be representing everything that's popular, pop culture, everything that people are believing at this time, politics, etc. But no matter how you look at this song, either if it's with the music industry, politics, media overstimulation, or whatever, there is a message that we can all take from the song, no matter how you look at it. In the bridge, which is probably the strongest point of the song, Christian says, there's no time to be yourself, and time, it's always slipping through our hands, we're busy making other plans, and even though time is fleeting, we're always trying to be someone else instead of doing what we really believe, what we really like. And I think maybe with the lyrics, love everyone, you don't have to think about loving everyone as in like loving your neighbor as the Ten Commandments suggest, but also love everyone includes loving yourself, which is what a lot of the topics on this EP are talking about. They're talking about kind of coming to love yourself or be happy. Don't try and follow what other people think just to fit in. You want to do what you actually believe in. You want to be yourself, or else all your time on this life has been wasted. You've wasted your life away trying to be someone else instead of doing what you enjoy. I hope you guys liked this little analysis of Kids in Droves. I really like this song, and I hope you guys really like it too. Totally give it a listen. Kids in Droves by Velvet Starlings. And until next time, thanks guys for watching, and remember to play it loud. Okay, I am hooked up to this thing and I can't move. Yay! It's like an IV. Intravenous star. Is this microphone even working? Love is waving goodbye. Allusion to John Lennon, and I'm being super mad for no apparent reason at all. I'm dead if you can't tell.
I like pie.